You're watching UNICEF television. Congested traffic and overcrowded markets gives a clear illustration of why Nigeria is sub-Saharan Africa's most populous country. In rural areas such as Benue State, this may be a little less obvious. But remote villages, under-resourced local population councils, and poor data management systems brings to the fore the challenges of documenting Nigeria's growing number of children.
In the rural areas, the level of registration is low because of lack of understanding, the level of illiteracy, awareness, lack of awareness, and the terrain, because you need to get a bike to go to an interior area to enlighten them, and it involves moving runs.
As a result, children in rural areas are less likely to be registered than urban children. Fewer than 42% of Nigeria's children under the age of 5 have a birth certificate. And UNICEF estimates that Nigeria will see the highest absolute rise in its child population by 2025 of any other country. Without this simple but valuable document, children can't legally access social services such as schools and are vulnerable to abuses like child trafficking. So to account for this rapidly growing population and address challenges associated with getting children registered, the government, through the support of UNICEF and partners, has established a data entry and management monitoring system called RapidSMS. This is how it works. At the Yaikyo local government health clinic, Al Onmoya is getting her son Emmanuel registered. Emmanuel's details are filled into a white form. At the end of a 20-minute consultation, Al receives her son's yellow birth certificate.
It's important for my son to have his birth certificate in order for him to identify with his country or nationality in Nigeria.
Twice a month, Tindia, one of 3,000 registrars across the country, will send Emmanuel's data along with all the other children he's registered to a central database via SMS.
I mean, I put in my own special code and put the SMS and send the data.
This data can be viewed on a public dashboard, which is monitored by Samuel Ogela at the Benue State Vital Registration Department.
So it is easy now to monitor them in my office than before. And that has increased the registration in the state.
Once a month, the white forms are collected from each registrar and sent to the State Data Collection Center, where the information is cross-checked with the SMS data. Every 3 months, the forms are sent to a data processing center, where physical information is transformed into electronic data in the national system. It is indeed a lengthy process and not without challenges. But for the first time, managers at a local level are able to identify bottlenecks and discrepancies early on.
Now that we have very detailed localized data, NPOPC can actually make much more specific intervention addressing specific problem area.
This system provides a clearer picture of birth registration in Nigeria, where problems are and how they can be solved, which ultimately translates into more children being able to access their fundamental right of having a birth certificate. This is Suzanne Birkes reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, go to unicef.org.